And today I'm going to be doing an unboxing and a review of the Griffin Studio Connect. You can pick these up at Amazon, or I got mine at Sweetwater. They run from about like $50 to $100, depending on where you get it. So let's go ahead and open her up. So this is the piece that you will connect your iPad to, looks like. And then it'll just rest in here, I guess. You have your power supply. That's one feature that I kind of like about this is it will apparently charge your iPad while it's plugged in, which is nice, so you can not have to stop working on music to charge your iPad up. Where does this plug into? Right there. And it looks like it comes with a little instruction manual, and that's about it. So I'm gonna try her out, and I will be back with a review for you guys.
All right, so I have the Griffin Studio Connect set up in my home studio now, and I have the back audio quarter inch input is coming from my mixer down here, and into that mixer I have plugged into a turntable and my guitar and bass. And I also have, with the MIDI input in the back, that is plugged into the MIDI output of my audio interface, which is running into my computer, which is running Ableton Live. And hooked up to my computer, I have a MIDI keyboard as well as some MIDI drums. And it's pretty cool because I can actually use everything at the same time, all hooked up in GarageBand. And also I have the audio from the Griffin, the audio out of the headphones is running into the audio input of my audio interface. So that's all running into Ableton Live. So I'll zoom in on the Ableton setup here so you guys that have Ableton can see how it's all set up. I'm also have a microphone that's running that's I'm recording my vocals through right now. So let's open up the piano in GarageBand. And as you can see, the piano works. And let's try the drums out. That works as well. And I have the guitar amp opened up, and let's just strum these guitars real quick. So as you can see, everything works pretty well. So this big blue button will control the output sound of the headphone output, and then this knob on the side will control your input. So far I'm pretty happy with the Griffin Studio Connect. If you want to be able to interface your iPad or iPhone with your computer in your home studio, I'd highly recommend you picking it up. Let me show you, it actually does work with an iPhone as well. So I now have GarageBand loaded up on my iPhone, and let's see how it works out. Zoom up a little bit. as you can see, it works pretty good. I also like how it will hold your phone or your iPad for you. So yeah, I highly recommend you checking it out and picking one up if you're looking for a nice little audio interface for your iPhone or your iPad. So that's going to conclude this review on the Griffin Studio Connect. Thank you.